Zanzibar to be called Tanzania.
This word an idea which was brought by our faith to
help most of our Tanzania to alleviate the situation which we are passing from. And in order to overcome it, he decided to come with the policy known as socialism for self-reliance.
Socialism for self-reliance had got several reasons and had got different impacts which came to rise after the adoption of that policy. And why we decided to call our own
government leaders who are not supposed to own different projects rather than being employed on their position, but therefore not allowed to be involved in business activities. Major means of production was amalgamated to be owned by the government.
And heavy institutions were supposed to be under the government. No one was supposed to own his own company or any private major means of production. So it is from there whereby all the industries were amalgamated to be owned by the government. All projects, all schools, all hospitals were decided to be owned by the government. And from there, different policies were established. For instance, the communal villages were established, and they were established in 1973. And the major means of establishing communal villages were to unite all people together, to work together, and allow the government to be capable in providing different social services together. For instance, the government decided to build the hospitals, which would be used by all people within their village, decided to establish hospitals which were supposed to be used with the whole people within their government. And therefore, when people used to work together, initiated on fighting against exploitation, which was erupted from the independence.
Sorry, if I can ask.
Yes.
So, you say all means of production were owned by government.
Yeah, tend to be owned by the government.
And government workers were not allowed to own any business.
Yes.
So, what happened to the business that were already existed, that were not owned by government?
Of course, in the implementation of Arusha Declaration or Socialism for Self-Reliance, Manjusu Kambarage Nyerere faced the biggest challenge in convincing people to allow their business to be attended by the government. And most of people, for instance, most of Tanzanians were poor and were not owning a lot of business, but we speak about Asians who decided to continue living in our country. We speak about other white people.
Asians were the ones who owned major business.
Yeah.
Okay.
A lot of business were owned by them. For instance, and we are speaking about Othmani Chan, who was owning an industry. Mm. So when Julius Kambarage Nyerere decided to establish this Boris, he decided to convince them, and you may see that most of them at first they regretted that Boris, but at later they decided to join Manjusu Kambarage Nyerere because they said that we are doing that not because of our own but because of our country. Myself, I can be rich, but yourself can't. We must supposed to unite together and share what we've got together. Those are all people can eat.
So they were supposed to be equality.
What he needed was all about equality, sharing equal the nation cakes, and that's why he decided to take over all the business which were only private, so that all people may be together. Whenever you are president, myself, I'm not a president, I'm not supposed to be jealous with you. All of us, we must be clear, equal, and that's why he decided to make all the people who were owning different aspects on their own to be together with them. And it took a long time, but it is to the moment where people decided to accept it. And
when was it accepted now?
There is no official here, but people started in a little way, started to accept the situation. Others it took like a month, others even 6 months. But at later they accepted the situation and the policy was introduced. And therefore the policy got a momentum. And from 1969 up to 1977, it was when that force was highly motivated, and it was when people started to get the national care concerning with their aspects. Therefore, there is different chairs which were used by Manjusu Kambarage Nyerere in conducting that meeting. This building was used by Manjusu Kambarage Nyerere with his cabinet.
This same building?
Yeah, this building where we are standing.
Okay.
So so that that meeting could be held. And when you come back in the building, that red chair.
Okay.
Beside him, there was a prime minister at that time who was known as Rashid Kawawa.
Rashid Mfaume Kawawa. Okay.
Rashid Mfaume Kawawa. And therefore, beside him, there was a chief secretary at that moment who was known as Oscar Kambona.
Oscar Kambona.
And
okay.
This chair was used by other cabinets.
Other cabinet members.
Yeah. Okay. And their names have been mentioned over here. So them who attended to that meeting, the member of our nation at that moment, member of our government. So all of them
who attended the Arusha Declaration meeting.
The Arusha Declaration meeting discussing on how that policy would be implemented. The pictures trying to indicate different people who are moving from their places in order to join in.
So this Arusha Declaration. Which I understand was formation of Jamaa village.
Yeah.
So people were moved from where they stay to form new villages. Is that so?
There is some new villages which were formed.
Mm-hmm.
In Hoda. And the main purpose of forming all the villages was what? Was to unite all people together so that when the government will start to provide different social services needed, all people must get it equal. We are discussing about, for instance, Tanzania has got different tribes where people are living far away from one to another. So in order for people to share the national cake, he insisted all people to unite together so that the government could be capable to provide services. And therefore the people could be used in producing different products which were needed by our nation at that moment, specifically industrial projects, industrial goods which could be used to be manufactured and you produce different items. So people were supposed to have different villages for production purpose as well as to initiate equal, to initiate unit, as well as to initiate the power of working on their own.
Okay.
Yes.
And when was the declaration or the Arusha Declaration abolished?
Arusha Declaration, we may not say Arusha Declaration. Arusha Declaration is still existing. But
okay, yeah, the declaration is still, yes. Socialism, yes.
Socialism for self-reliance, despite of being succeeded, but there were different challenges which faced it. And those challenges, all the causes which faced to the collapse of socialism for self-reliance, have been based in a different matter. There is those which were long present in different circumstances which happened and initiated to the collapse of reason for self-reliance in Tanzania. Different reasons are like a long drought which happened, and you know the government in socialism was supposed to provide each and everything to its people. So they had a greatest battle in fighting or in supplying those aspects why there was a long drought. Mm-hmm. The war between Tanzania and Uganda in 1978 up to 1979 discouraged that policy because the government had to take a loan from outside in order to revamp the economy which was destructed during that war, and that initiated to the collapse of our socialism. We speak about the collapse of the USSR, who were our master, who used to support us.
Okay.
And in 1992, we were not capable to move on our own, so it's where we decided to follow the procedures concerning the SAPA adjustment program. See if we could.
Structural adjusted program.
Yeah.
So that was started in 1990?
And we started to implement it from 1992, whereby we established the multipartism in 1992 to allow the free election, which consisted more than one political party, and it came to happen in 1995. We decided to allow the second president at that moment, Ndugu Haya Sanemwenye, decided to go and ask for the loans from the capitalist nations because USSR were supporting us, they had already collapsed in different conditions. And one among the conditions was to allow multipartism, which was against socialism, to allow free trade, which was against socialism policy, to allow private major means of production, opening private, which was against socialism. And throughout those aspects, initiated it to the collapse of socialism. And that emerged during the rise of our second president of Tanzania. But specifically in 1992, it is when different aspects started to change and initiated it to the collapse of socialism in Tanzania. Though up to now there is no any document which indicates that socialism has collapsed in your country.
So it is it was informally
collapsed. Okay. Though when we see how people are implementing different aspects of the theory of capitalism, but when we focus to our document, they insist that we are still social. So we have got what we call mixed
economy or mixed system.
Yeah, but yeah, as long as we are going through, it will lead to the moment whereby capitalism will be declared free or total, because things have been changing throughout the way we get on, the way people are owning their own business.
Yeah, because now we have people who are very rich and people who are very poor. So I assume
the class is within our set.
Yes.
And that's what Mandela Magini really used to fight against, but it's already happened. We're speaking about the more daring and the backers who are holding a lot of amount within our nations. But speaking to other Tanzanians who cannot even afford.
Let me ask, do you think socialism, which was established by the Arusha Declaration, do you think it is a success? If now you look back now, in hindsight, do you think it was a success or it was a mistake? It's your honest opinion.
My own opinion.
Yes.
I'm interested that it succeeded. Because when we start to compare people who lived during that forest era and who were living in another era, there is a lot of gap between us with them. But in another aspect, for instance, Mr. Oscar Kambona, who was against that forest, he has said that socialism could take a lot of time to benefit to people. And when the socialism collapses, it was the moment whereby it had not already reached to its
highest
stage, people to fulfill it and people to benefit against it. So it was the moment whereby it was still growing up and integrated. So if we could continue with that voice up to this moment in a good way, all of us would enjoy it, but before it did not fulfill what we needed and it did not fulfill the expectations of one Muslim like in Nyerere, it's how we failed to reach where we aimed to be.
But even
the success which happened during that moment, we may say that most of people got an education. The number of literate people increased within our society, and you know, in that moment, people were studying freely, there was no any school fees. We speak about the hidden, there was the eruption of different industries in our country. We speak about the matrix, which was found in Rwanda. We speak about different industries which were happening during that moment. Therefore, we speak about exportation. Exportation, it was, but it didn't end forever. It didn't end totally, but still, people were capable to utilize their resources effectively comparing to our current situation, which are passing through. So you may see the crashes were not as well as the way they have been appearing right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, because...
But when we speak about the disadvantage of socialism during that moment, it was too expensive to be afforded with our country, because it was supposed to be sponsored by the government. All the staffs which were needed to the hospital were supposed to be sponsored by the government. All staff needed to the education system were supposed to be sponsored by the government. Roads, each and everything. People were supposed to work and the government was supposed to supply. But we are speaking currently where, but whenever you go to the hospital, you are the one who is supposed to pay on your treatments. Whenever you go to schools and you need better education, you are the one who is supposed to pay on your own. When you go to the university, you are the one who is supposed to pay. And not all people will be now given the loans. And even if you were given the loans, you are supposed to turn it back. So, during that moment, people enjoyed the life, and people were capable to reach their dreams. Comparing right now, you may have your own dream, but because of the system, you may fail to fulfill it.
Well, from the stories, we hear that during this Ujamaa, that people who owned things, material things, you know, They were destroying those things because if they were caught owning those things, they were taken as sabotaging the economy and they could be jailed. Is that true? How can you speak about that?
As long as there is no documents, well, I can get that.
From your experience?
According to my experience.
Yes.
You know, myself, I've been reading a lot of books concerning with Myanmar. Myanmar and the whole aspect which happened in Myanmar. I didn't get that point. Maybe I may say that, let me continue cross-checking that aspect to see whether I... But I didn't see it. And of course, there have been different rumors. For instance, the Vinod Manichandi,
I recall stories that, you know, if you own sugar, even sugar, for example, people had to destroy sugar, had to destroy cooking oil because they were not allowed.
No, that
they were considered as economic sabotage.
We are speaking to the moment whereby socialism was affected and it was at the end of collapsing. It's when that era started to happen. It started to happen after the end of Tanzania-Uganda war. It costed about $500 million.
The war?
Yeah, the war. And that man was not even in our budget. You know, when the war happened, the government was supposed to enter. There is no a war. There is no a war budget which can be at many will use 500 or what. So the government found the biggest debt which had ever happened. So we know that
actually, this is there's a summary of the war here.
The government, during that moment from 1979 up to the 1918th, the government was part in a difficult moment where they failed even to import those goods. For instance, we are speaking about sugar, we are speaking about salt, we are speaking about soaps. Those are social services, domestic items. So it was during that moment where the government had no enough capital, had no enough funding to offer to import those aspects from outside. So it's when they decided that in all of us to use together, let's each family buy 1 kilogram of sugar so that all people can get it. Let the other one only maybe one bar of soap so that all people can get it. So it was not about destroying it, but it was how did you get 2 kilos? Why we said that all of you must get 1 kilo. Though they needed all people to share what was at that moment. Though it was not enough for them.
Because people from that era are saying that they used to queue, to line up for basic stuff like soap, sugar,
As I said, that it was the moment where the government was passing in a dangerous or in a difficult moment after the end of the war.
So that was because of the war, it was not because of socialism.
There are not enough amount to ask to import sugar from Cuba, there are not enough amount to ask for different domestic items. So what they decided it was to use that which was over there effective for all people. It doesn't matter you've got a lot of amount, you will go to the shop and buy 5 kilos, while myself I can afford a single kilo. So all of us were supposed to buy in equal means so that we may use it effectively. But it was in the era whereby socialism was going to collapse.
Okay.
At the first, people were getting what they needed in equal.
If you look at other East African countries like Kenya and maybe Uganda, I think Kenya did not adopt socialism.
Kenya adopted capitalism.
Capitalism.
Uganda
so,
adopted socialism, which was on a man's common charter. That was the socialism of Uganda. So
my question is, do you think if Tanzania had adopted capitalism, probably maybe would be more developed and, more industrialized? Or what do you think about that?
Maybe I must be like other people in answering your question.
Yes.
For some of your question, I must say that it depends. Because during, for instance, the happening, for instance, Tanzania and Uganda war, which is estimated to be the one which decided the economy of Tanzania. If we do even erupt during that moment while we were in capitalism, still it could affect our economy. We speak about different fund which you got from USSR. It means that we could not get it.
Mm.
And maybe we could get from USA, but in which way?
But some people are saying that maybe Tanzanians are not very aggressive in terms of working culture and you know, just the general attitude to life. And some people are attributing this to socialism, ujamaa. What do you think of that?
Of course, even myself, I may say that because, you know, when we work together, and you know that even if you go to work, myself, I work, and we share together, such may affect their mindset, and of course, this has been happening when you compare Tanzanians and Kenya in different social affairs and economic affairs,
mm-hmm.
that Kenyan people are too much eager comparing to us. Because themselves, they've been fighting all over their lifetime with capitalism. So when even if you ask a little king that who you wish to be, he may tell that I wanna wish to own my own hotel. So his mindset, our mindset has been already corrupted that he must fight to own his own to employ himself.
He already have a capitalist mindset.
Yeah, capitalist mindset. Quite different with Tanzanians. For this one, you ask more a lot of kids, whom do you want to be? I want to be a doctor, to be employed by the government. I want to be a teacher, means that to be employed by the government. No one will tell you that I want to create my own company. I want to create my own hospital. I want to create my own supermarket. You know why? Because socialism primarily has to be owned by the government, to be serving the government, to be served by different people. So instead of fighting for our own, we were already, Manvista Maine prepared us to work for togetherness. Though that's the problem. The system have changed, but our mindset have not yet changed.
Mm.
People to stand on their own, to fight on their own. They need what we call brotherhood and sisterhood. We need the connections. We need all of us to be employed by the government. Why it may not happen?
Yeah, the government has no capacity to.
And that's one among the greatest bitterness which we need. Which we have received from socialism.
Okay.
So you can't compare them with Kenya. Kenya are good on what we call entrepreneurships. Little people can conduct good projects, can conduct the biggest projects.
Mm.
But for us, we need time, we need to work hard.
So I remember there.
First of all, we may say that it was like the way I've said that.
Like a statement.
Was not supposed to.
Oh, they're like rules.
Yeah, they put it at the rules.
Mm-hmm. So maybe just to mention them.
That's the first, someone was not allowed to own another aspect if he was a reader. For this, if you're a reader, you're supposed to be committed with your position which you're given.
You are not supposed to have any other business. Okay.
Major means of production were supposed to be owned by the government.
State ownership of all cooperation and business.
Yes. And therefore, it encouraged you about units, it encouraged you about unit, another aspect which may be different with the units.
I think they also started those ujamaa villages.
Yes, they insisted about forming villages which could be
communal village.
Which could be communal village, all people to share that. But most of our aspects were that one, to have a single political party.
A single political party, okay.
So that's what was done, and it turned to be the same. So it means that we had a single political party, and the main purpose then they came that it was to bring all people together. Because when we have different political parties, they thought that people would be separated and have different mindsets and fight.